Hi, welcome to the Microsoft Dynamics GP 2018 new feature video. My name is Isaac Olson and I'm a senior support engineer for Microsoft Dynamics GP. I want to start off by thanking you for your product suggestions. Majority of the features in Microsoft Dynamics GP 2018 came from suggestions of customers just like you. Let's get started by listing off each of the new features in Microsoft Dynamics GP 2018. Turn off garnishment reports. Purchase order number added to purchase requisition navigation list for procurement. Ability to roll down from setup on payroll and human resources for inactive and active records. Print and email a single statement from the customer card. Print purchase requisitions, save select payment settings, copy user access across analytical accounting dimension codes. One check per invoice vendor setting. Reprint distribution detail and summary reports. Doc attach added to more areas. Receivings transaction entry window. General ledger transaction entry window. Employee inquiry, I-9 form, fixed assets, asset general information, and more. OData version 4, GP Power BI content pack, additional sorting added to select bank transactions window, payables transaction inquiry windows, and receivables transaction inquiry windows. Renamed payables windows from check to payments, smart list password per smart list, wellness and health insurance integration. Display hold status on sales transaction entry window. Purchase order generator opens the purchase order list with new PO filter. Exclude inactive deduction code filters added to deduction lookup window. One-click access to smart list in web client. Bank reconciliation maximized window in web client. Autocomplete in web client. Update sample data date and documentation. General ledger account approval workflow. Purchasing invoice approval workflow. Purchasing receivings transaction workflow. Copy workflow step. Payable transaction workflow additional fields. Vendor workflow additional fields for EFT bank information. Reporting for workflow. Purchase order notification to requisition originator. Email reminders for workflow. Purchase order workflow messages additional fields. HRMSS employee email changes for time cards. Project time and expense PTE email approval functionality. Now I'm going to demonstrate a few of my favorite features. Let's start with purchase order notification to requisition originator. With this new feature on your home page in GP, if you open the procurement tab, you will see a list of your most recent requisitions. As you can see, requisition 1 was submitted and completed, but it has not been purchased. Requisition 2 and 3 have both been purchased. Previous to Microsoft Dynamics GP 2018, we did not display which PO number the requisition was transferred to. Now the user has a reference if they need to look up the PO that was created based on the requisition. Let's take a quick look at the web client where we added features like one-click access to smart list and autocomplete. In my web client, you will notice that I have one-click access to smart list on my menu bar at all times. Also, Let's say that I enter a purchase requisition. Our autocomplete feature will suggest previously typed items in for me, just like the rich client. I can save my purchase requisition, and without even closing the window, I can go straight to my smart list. From here, I can expand and open smart list right in my web client. Reminder emails for workflow. Reminder emails are available under all of the workflow types in your workflow maintenance window. For example, if I go to purchase requisition approval, you can see that if a task is overdue, it'll automatically be rejected. If I go to any of my workflow steps, I can set a custom reminder time for each step so that the approver, when there's 2 hours remaining before the task will be overdue, will get a reminder email. For example, in this case, if I submit a requisition, my approver, Isaac Olson, will have a time limit of 8 hours to approve it before the workflow will automatically reject. When there's 2 hours remaining, Isaac will receive a reminder email. Here's an example of how this email would look. Reporting for workflow. Our workflow history report is going to be under Reports, Company, Workflow History. You can save options. For example, I could create a workflow requisition history for Isaac. I can sort it by the type, the user, completion date, or due date. I'm going to sort mine by the completion date. I can choose to include or exclude the comments when a user submits. I'm going to filter on just the workflow type of purchasing requisitions. And then I'm also going to filter on my user . Set your destination just like our other reports with options, and now I can print. You can see a list of requisitions under Isaac Olson, and for example, when I submitted this one, I put a note that said it's for this project number. Or on this requisition, I put, make sure Bob double checks my accounts before approving. This is just a nice way to get a report of what's out there and its current status. The final feature that I'll be demonstrating today is the GP Power BI Content Pack. If you open AppSource and Power BI Online and search on Microsoft Dynamics GP, you can find our new content pack available for use. This content pack is full of predefined reports that uses your GP data. For example, we have financial reports, sales reports, purchasing reports, and inventory reports that are all predefined using your data. If I go to sales, I can zoom into the map and see where most of my sales are coming from. I can also change the years, and you can see all of my reports will adjust according to whichever year that I select. These are just a few of the reports of the many that come predefined with this content pack. This concludes the Microsoft Dynamics GP 2018 video demonstration. As a reminder, I just picked out my favorite features to show you. There are many more. You can check these out on our new feature blog series for GP 2018 or on the Microsoft Dynamics GP directory. Once again, my name is Isaac Olson. I'm a senior support engineer with Microsoft Dynamics GP, and thank you for watching.